This series is for everyone, whether you're very new to modding or if you're an experienced user. With or without knowledge, this guide will help you make the most of new horizons. We're going to go over dumping the romFs in this video, or its assets in general files, of Animal Crossing, to edit with Switch Toolbox. In the later parts of this series, we'll be going over multiple programs that allow you to edit the contents of the romFs to import game mods. Before you get excited, realize that mods can only be used on modded Switches. If you want to check if your Switch can be modded, follow the written guide for help. I should also note that I will not be going over NHSC, as that's save editing and not modding. However, Clutch has some great videos you can watch if you're planning to make a treasure island. You can ask in his Discord or mine for assistance. Obviously, to edit the game's files, you're going to need them. An XDump tool allows you to dump the romFs of the game. You can download it from this link. Just download the NRO and place it in a Switch folder on your SD card. You'll also need to dump your prod and title keys using lockpick RCM. Download the bin and place it in a bootloader payloads folder on your SD. Now inject Hecate. After doing so, select payloads and then lockpick. Select dump from sysnam by pressing the power button. You'll see some flashy colors and a confirmation that the keys are written to where they needed to be. Press the power button again to return to the menu, then navigate to reboot RCM. Boot custom firmware and launch any game via title takeover, opening the game while holding R. It's better to launch homebrew apps this way as it gives them full system resources. When the homebrew launcher opens, navigate to NXDump tool. Here, the process differs a bit if you own the game physically instead of digitally. Press dump game card content if you do own it physically, otherwise press dump installed SD card / AMMC content. Select the game and then romFs options. If it's available to you, use your left or right buttons to cycle through the available updates for the game so you can dump those as well. The option won't show if you don't have any available updates. Make sure split files bigger than 4GB is also selected. Now select the romFs section data dump and wait for the process to finish. How long it takes depends on your SD card speed. And now, your romFs is dumped. You should copy the romFs folder from your SD card to your PC, as the romFs is 6GB or higher. It also makes it easier to edit whenever it's needed instead of only editing when your SD card's in your computer. Switch Toolbox is what you'll be using to extract the game's files, to edit them, and re-import to get those changes to show up in-game. Get Switch Toolbox by going to the GitHub and downloading Toolbox latest.zip. Despite the date, this build is automatically updated from the latest commit, so you'll always have the most recent release. Extract a zip using 7-zip and open the folder. Inside you'll see toolbox.exe, and that's what you want to open. Remember when I said to copy the romFs from your Switch to your PC? Hopefully you did and remember the location you saved it to. Click File, Open, Folder, then select the directory you saved it to. You'll be greeted with these folders on screen, and the name tells you the contents of them. While most of it's self-explanatory, look on screen to see what they represent. In future parts of this series, I'll go over multiple tools that are used to edit the game's romFs. Tools such as Blender to edit the models, Kuriimu to edit dialog, and more. For now though, if you're following along with the series, you'll need to do some things that will make your life a whole lot easier. First, you should create the layered.fs folder. The layered.fs is what actually allows you to load in the edited game files. In Atmosphere, Contents, create a new folder which has the title ID of Animal Crossing. The ID is on screen and in the description for copying. Once this folder is created, make another called romFs inside it. Create the directory system/resource and create a new resource size table. This can be done by creating an empty text file and renaming it to ResourceSizeTable.srsizetable. Under normal circumstances with ACNH, loading a file that's much larger or smaller than the original causes the game to crash. This file disables the game's RAM management, so it will load any mod no matter the size. Once we do get to creating mods, they must follow the same naming scheme as in the romFs, or the mod will not load. So if you edit the dialog, then you need to create a folder called message and add any archives in there. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like the video and subscribe for future releases in the series. Leave a comment or join my Discord if you have an issue, and I'll do my best to respond. My website has this video and future ones that aren't in video form completed. So if you'd rather read through the guide now instead of waiting for the video, go ahead. I also stream on Twitch, so follow there too. I do speedruns of ACNH and Treasure Island sometimes.